Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Mountain Harmony Gardening. I'm Kristen, and fall has come early to my garden, as you can see behind me, and we are going to have to harvest a lot today, and I'm going to be showing you what we're doing. Unfortunately, the powdery mildew has absolutely taken over early on this pumpkin and spaghetti squash plant. And I'm just gonna have to take them out. They're not gonna produce anymore. And you can see that we've got some really big spaghetti squash here. There's a pumpkin here, one there, a couple more spaghetti squash. And even behind the camera, we've got another pumpkin back there. So this isn't gonna produce anymore. And I'm just gonna have to take it out. I know that it's earlier than we normally take these out, but as you can see, this is an absolute total mess. And you're probably wondering, are you going to leave these outside to kind of finish curing? Unfortunately, I can't, because all of our Landrys, our squirrels, are really starting to take a toll on my garden in other areas. And last year they did try to eat some of these. So I'm going to bring them all into the house to let them finish ripening. So let's get to work. That didn't take too long to clean up. I think what took the longest was probably taking off all of the clips off of the trellis. There were a lot of them. I think I use them more on the squash than I do on the tomatoes. So you can see that down beside the shed, we now do not have plants everywhere. They were actually starting to root themselves into the mulch that we have on the ground. I went ahead and cleaned up all the plants that we are leaving. We are going to be harvesting the basil probably today and making pesto, because our weather has been starting to get pretty cold and you could see that they're turning yellow. They're not gonna last much longer. But look at the harvest we've got. We've got five of the spaghetti squash and four of the pumpkins. Plus we still have some of these in the house that we've been harvesting. So I think this trellis did fantastic this year. This is more of a harvest than we've ever gotten before. So this was definitely a win this year, changing the trellis up. Now I do have our little cups that we were using this year to keep all the roly-polies out, and they worked fantastic. But because of the powdery mildew, I'm just gonna go ahead and rinse these off and recycle them, because I do not wanna risk using these again next year and spreading powdery mildew into the rest of the garden. So we're gonna go ahead and get rid of these. The next thing that we need to do is we need to go ahead and take these out too. These actually completely died back maybe about a week or so ago, and we're going to take them off. And also the cucumbers that are down here have pretty much finished off for the season. They can, you know, go, because they've got powdery mildew on them too. So I want to go ahead and take all of this out today. I want to harvest everything we can and start preserving it, because if I don't do that now, we are going to lose all of this wonderful harvest, because our nights are already starting to get so cold, and it's very unexpected for this time of the year. Usually we kind of get Indian summer where it lasts longer, but this year I can tell we are not. So I'm going to get this all cleaned up with Donnie's help, and then I'll show you what we did when we come back. We have all the cucumbers and the other little melons all taken out, so this whole entire area is clean. We cleaned up the huge Swiss chard a little bit better so we can see underneath it now. The tomatoes still have a ways to go. They don't mind a little bit cooler weather like this. It's just the melons absolutely do not. And you can see behind me, hopefully, look at all those ripe tomatoes in the garden. We're definitely going to be making some more salsa of those. But the melons on the other side where the kajaris are and the watermelon that we have are definitely done. We're going to be taking that out next, and I'm going to show you that process. Another thing you also want to do is go ahead and pull up all of your plant tags now. That way you don't have to try to find them once all the leaves have fallen. So I'm on the side of the garden with Aragog, and hopefully you guys will get the reference for that one, because this is definitely the largest spider that we have, and it's still hiding underneath our sunflower. And I'm going to be careful not to disturb Aragog while we're taking all this out. But you can see that all of the melons have died back. Look at that. And now we should be able to find all the kajaris pretty easy. And we'll go ahead and even take in the smaller ones. and we're going to let them ripen in the house because I've done that with a couple others and they turn out just fine. So we'll be right back after you take all of this and hopefully not my nasturtiums because they're growing in here out. One thing I forgot is I should probably show you how I'm taking these out. Luckily, I have all the cups here because of the roly-polies this year, so I know where all of the plants actually have their roots based at, even though I know they can root in the ground as they're growing. So I'm just going down and I'm cutting them off at ground level, taking the cups out and saving these ones because these ones are okay to save. And that way you leave all of the nutrients in the ground when you're taking these out because you don't want to rip that out. That's food for the good bugs that are in the soil. We have all the melon plants taken out and I was able to kind of detangle with Donnie's help the nasturtium from the melons. And we have this bed all cleaned up. But now we are going to need to take out the sunflowers because if you look at the top of this, you can see that the Landrys have pretty much taken off almost all the flowers on our sunflowers. Donnie can pan around for you and show you in the pepper bed what the sunflowers look like after the Landrys have gotten to them. So we're not saving but a few of the seeds for the birds because some of them, the sunflowers are really small and they're not the edible variety. I mean, I guess you could, but they'd be really tiny. But we're going to go ahead and take them all out and hopefully this will deter the Landrys from getting in the garden and destroying the tomatoes because I did find a few tomatoes that they've been trying to eat in the garden. So I want to take out as many attractants as I can out of the garden for them. I know it's the end of the season and these leaves look horrible, but the ones up here don't look that bad. And in some of the other plants, they're actually doing really well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and trim off all the leaves except for a few at the top. And see, like this one didn't even make it. Like this plant may not make it completely, but I wanted to give you a good example that we could actually see on camera. I want to show you what I'm doing. And it's taking off all the powdery mildew leaves. Taking off that one too. And if they have any signs of powdery mildew, they're just coming off. Take that one off. And I know that looks kind of drastic and sad, but I want to try to save it because some of these are doing so good that I want to see if I can get some more zucchini out of them. So once I've finished up all these other plants, we'll come back and I'll show you what it all looks like. This looks dramatically different because there were so many powdery mildewy leaves, but we were able to tie them back up again. They still have some good leaves on the top. And they'll right themselves as they're stood up straight. Probably it'll take a couple days or so. But Socks has found herself a really good spot to nap. But she's not going to be happy with me because the next thing to come out are all of this fennel because I do not use it anymore and it didn't bulb up. But the other thing that we're also going to be harvesting is look at all of the carrot seeds. Let's see if I can get a couple out because they've been sticking kind of to me. So there are some of the carrot seeds, and I let this one go. It was from last year, specifically because I want to save the seeds from it because they worked really well in my garden. So I'm going to find probably like this one's probably the driest head of them all, and I just need one. And the rest I'm probably going to just cut and sprinkle into the garden. If they come up, great, free seeds. Well, that probably took us an hour or two to get the garden completely ready for the fall. All of our summer plants that will not make it through this colder weather are all gone, and we've only left the plants that are going to survive through a little bit colder weather. But another thing that Donnie reminded me of is he saw another YouTube gardener saving his sunflower stems and drying them out and using them as stakes. And since this one is well taller than me, which I'm a little bit over 5 feet tall, and most of my garden stakes are shorter than me, this will make a really good stake next year, probably for the other sunflowers. We're gonna save it. Another thing that I wanted to mention is do not compost powdery mildew leaves. You want to throw those away. We threw all of ours away in the garbage, and you're gonna get rid of them. And then we're gonna put down a nice, thick fresh layer of compost to kind of combat that powdery mildew, because you don't want it getting on your plants next year and just causing problems. And this was a bad problem this year with all the rain. In fact, we haven't been able to get out here to even mow the grass, which is getting really long. And now that it's nice and sunny, we're going to take care of that today too. Look at everything that we got out of our garden. We got some kunjari, some spaghetti squash, we got some onions, a branch of the tomatillos broke off, we got some dill, and we also got some cucumbers and zucchini and carrots and sunflowers and pumpkins, kale, and more squash at the end, plus our sunflower stems too. So that was a lot that we got out of our garden. And by the time you guys see this, it will be right past our 1 year anniversary. I can't believe it. I'm so excited. We are almost to the 500 mark on our subscribers too. So don't forget to share this with your friends, because we want to have that giveaway for that Baker Creek gift card that I'm going to be giving out. So thanks for watching, everyone. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and comment. Happy gardening, everyone.